What are you doing here?
Hey.
Did you do this?
Why are you here?
Are you on that ship now?
Ati.
Te mata kia ia e ma. Ua hoki hoki katoa.
He's all right.
No, Mum, he's not all right. He's changed.
The story I've described is about a Kuia, a Māori grandmother, who refuses to give up on her pea-addicted grandson. But in my own whānau, we have a pea problem on both sides of my family. So I've got extended family members, and I've just seen how this drug has been hard on them. You know, some have recovered, some haven't. And so it's just a continuous struggle. As a journalist for the last 20 years, I noticed that we were doing more and more stories on this epidemic. And I was going into homes of different stories about people who are affected by P, addicts, family members. A school friend of mine actually was murdered in Australia. He was it was a pee-induced situation as well. So there were just these things that were happening in my life and in my professional life that kind of exposed me to this problem. And so that kind of inspired me to want to write it.
Nan, we gotta go.
Well, why don't you stay for a kite, eh? Look like you could do with a good feed.
I'm all good, Nan.
You've always been a good kid.
A lot of films or narratives surrounding drugs, and pee in particular, are quite glamorised. So they're set in the gang world or on the streets. And you know, what I had seen is that this problem is actually closer to home for most people. So that was very deliberate to want to kind of change the narrative, because that's where this problem or this addiction, the most impact it has, is within the intimate setting, the sanctuary of the home. The film itself, it doesn't offer a solution. That was quite deliberate on my front, because in life, it doesn't always end happily, or it's not easily solved, you know. Addiction and then dealing with addiction, or dealing with family or whānau who are in this state of addiction is hard, you know, it's a struggle. And it's not easy. You know, it is the reality within our community. It's a reality, it's growing within our Pacific community as well. And it's a drug that doesn't have any prejudice, you know. It affects all cultures, all socioeconomic levels, all different types of families. And I think because of that, people are very open to have a discussion in any way that they can have that, whether it be through a short film or whether it be through the many support groups there are for pee addiction. People are open to that because that is a problem.